The New Orleans Saints paid left guard Andrus Peat five-year deal worth $57.5 million, $33 million of that guaranteed per ESPN. Saints also making moves over the weekend on the offensive side. On the outside, veteran wide receiver Emmanuel Sanders agreed to terms with the New Orleans Saints on a two-year deal. Plus, they agreed to a one-year deal with backup cornerback core special teams player Justin Hardee and fullback Michael Burton. ESPN confirmed on Sunday that the Saints were bringing in safety DJ Swearinger. So an active weekend for New Orleans down in Metairie.
Yeah, very active weekend. How they are going to make this all work in their current cap setup is unclear to many. But as we know, Kai Harley and Mickey Loomis will find a way to mathematically get it done. And because there's a bit of a dearth of sports news, Jordy, I really thought about these Emmanuel Sanders moves, and I really like it. And I'll explain those thoughts coming up next.
What about Andrus Peat?
That one's more interesting. Mm-hmm. I that was less of a. I don't. I'm like everybody else. I don't think I love the move. I tried to put myself into the Saints front office headspace and say, okay, how did we arrive at the numbers that they landed on? As Jordy's alluding to, Andrus Peat signs a 5-year,
$57.5 million, 33 of it guaranteed.
Damn, which. Not a lot of people saw coming. So we'll break down exactly how that came about.
Tom Brady is officially the Tampa Bay Buccaneers' new starting quarterback. Sources at ESPN told Adam Schefter that the deal is 2 years worth $50 million, and all of that is guaranteed. It also includes another $9 million in incentives, $4.5 million in incentives per year, and the contract prohibits tags, trades, per sources.
I don't know that I have any great commentary on it, but if you want to read a really interesting piece about the Brady-Belichick-Patriots breakup, on ESPN.com right now, Seth Wickersham has an excellent article that breaks down kind of the last few years and how it could, because to me, at least down here, not being so in touch with the New England news cycle, every time you heard about kind of cracks in the armor or you saw one of these articles where Brady and Belichick were getting along, like, did you ever really believe it? I never really believed it. I always thought, like, this is just people making this sensationalized. It's people making something out of nothing. But hindsight's 2020. And, yeah, it looks like probably for the past, like, 3 years, it's kind of been a business. Things haven't been very rosy up in New England. So, of course, Tom Brady wants to go play for Bruce Arians.
It seemed like the trigger point was Jimmy Garoppolo. It seemed like a couple of years back, Belichick said that they wanted to trade Brady and keep Garoppolo, and Brady then teamed up with Kraft, and he said, look, it's either me or him, and they got rid of Garoppolo at the time. They kept Brady, Belichick, and him. It seemed like it kind of turned
bad. And then they refused to – Brady reportedly wanted a multi-year deal. He wanted to be like, look, I'm playing until I'm 45. I want y'all to give me that contract, and I'll be in here till New England. Until then, New England wanted to continue at that year-to-year basis, and then, I mean – look, how much time can you work with someone that you love before you feel like it's maybe run its course? Much less someone like Bill Belichick, who would just like be so grating. And I get that you win, but how nice is it going to be to go from Bill Belichick to Bruce Arians?
I mean,
tell people about y'all. I mean, how long can you work with people you love before they just start to grate at you?
Well, guess what? Why don't you go have another baby or something, and you can get yourself a nice little extended break.
I'll miss you after 3 months.
You want to start playing with the afternoon guy? You want to hang with the afternoon guy?
Hey, by the way,
speaking of that, the
vote
the
for
polls,
Madison Gilmore.
The polls are posted at the Twitter account at 1045 ESPN, at Off the Bench, at OTB_ESPN. Mm-hmm. Is where you can vote on the ESPN personality bracket that is up and first rounds right now, active. A lot of votes. ESPN even casted their votes early this morning.
Yes, somebody that has access to the ESPN Twitter account got on there this morning, Rivs did a little sleuthing, and they voted on two polls. They voted for Matthew Musso and Matt Moscona. I wonder.
Musso, he loves to get up at 5 a.m.
I wonder who those could
Twitter.
Be. I will say this. I would hate to see Madison Gilmore beat Matt Moscona first round. I mean, that would just be... Because right then, like, are the polls even legit? I would just hate to see that happen. So if you want to go vote, OTB_ESPN on Twitter, go over there, find that Madison versus Matt matchup. And like I said, just definitely don't vote for Madison, but do.
It's only happened one time in March history.
Yeah.
In tournament history, a 16-1. I mean,
UMGC?
BC.
But what about UMGC? Okay. University of Madison Gilmore college. Yeah. How about that?
2020 Summer Olympics, to safeguard the health of all involved and to contribute to the containment of COVID-19, the Executive Board of the International Olympic Committee announced they will step up the scenario planning for the games in Tokyo. The two scenarios are to modify existing operational plans for the games to go ahead on July 24th and change the start date. Hey, look, it ain't happening this year.
That's what I'm saying, dude. Canada
it
said
it ain't happening.
Why can't they let it go?
Well, I mean, look, there's so much inertia, I think, behind something like that. And even for these athletes, man, I feel like Olympics are always weird to me and Olympians because the timing of the event has to just time up with your natural biological timing, right? And it's so, I think, frustrating to have to move all those pieces around. But I think Canada said they're not going if the Olympics are still on. The U.S. is given, I think, a month for Tokyo to figure it out. So, yeah, it ain't, I don't think it's happening, man.
They will continue to watch the rapidly changing development of the health situation around the world in Japan. Canada, ST said, won't send their athletes over to Tokyo unless the games are postponed by 1 year. The country's Olympic Committee announced Sunday night amid concerns over the COVID-19 pandemic.